Welcome to the channel. It's Dr. Durst. I'll introduce myself by saying that I have an office that specializes in regenerative medicine. And so we do everything from aesthetics, when somebody wants to finally look better, to wellness and sexual wellness. My specialty is wellness, sexual wellness. But I do PRP as a core offering for almost all of our services across the board, from sexual wellness to aesthetics. And so we frequently get asked questions because we use PRP for something specific and PRF. And so I want to talk about the difference between the two because we use it for so much. But before we get into all the details, I want you to like and subscribe, especially if you're interested in wellness, regenerative wellness, aesthetic topics, just very advanced procedures and all the things that you might not get that information elsewhere. So like, subscribe, and share if you like this video. So basically, PRP and PRF, those are blood products that we can use for regeneration. So we can inject those into tissue and get regeneration of different things, depending on what tissue we're injecting it in. So we're going to draw blood. We get the blood, spin it down, and process it to get the platelets. There's a concentration of platelets because they have growth factors in them. And PRP, we're spinning it really fast, and we're getting all the other stuff out. And then we have a concentration of platelets. Then we advanced on to what we call PRF, and it's processed differently. So almost think of it as comparing, remember the iPod where we used to listen to music on that little square device, and it was really hard to even work with. And, you know, again, it was just hard and it wasn't that great. And so then all of a sudden we moved on to an iPhone to listen to music. So we're just comparing a progression over time to a better processing or product. There's still a place for PRP, but for us, mainly it's in sexual wellness. The PRF, we're still drawing blood and we're spinning it down, but now we're not spinning it as fast and as long so that we're not taking everything else out of it. So in addition to the platelet concentration, you also have some white blood cells, you have some stem cells, so there's other growth factors in there because we haven't eliminated everything else. But we also don't put what we call an anticoagulant in the PRF. Anticoagulants keep things from clotting. So when we drew PRP, we put the anticoagulant in there, we'd have a long period of time because that blood we drew wouldn't clot, and then we can inject it. You can imagine that it's kind of hard to inject a clot, but you can easily inject a liquid, right? So if you're thinking about a shot that you're taking, somebody's injecting something, it's free flowing. That's liquid, a clot isn't. So we would put this anticoagulant in so that we could actually inject it. But again, that allowed for maybe disbursement of the growth factors after we injected it. So we progressed to doing PRF. So we don't put an anticoagulant in it. So we draw the blood, we spin it, we process it, and we need to use it pretty quickly for the PRF because it's going to form a clot after we inject, or it'll form a clot before if we take too much time. There are things that we have developed over time to process and to allow us a little more time to inject the PRF. But know that after we do inject it, it forms a clot, and that fibrin plug essentially is keeping those platelets in place, and then you have release of those growth factors over 2 to 3 weeks potentially versus just days. So the studies vary. It could be anywhere from 7 to up to 3 weeks, but a prolonged release of growth factors from those platelets. And if you think about PRF and PRP and what it can do, just think about cutting your arm. And if you cut your arm, the platelets go to the site and stop the bleeding. That's what we think is the only issue, but behind the scenes, those platelets are now releasing growth factors to stem cells in that particular area to regenerate tissue in that area. So if we're injecting it with hair, it's stimulating or communicating with the stem cells in the scalp. If we're doing it in vaginal or penile tissue, it's stimulating stem cells in that area. So it will regrow what's specific to that area based on stem cell communication. But just know that the difference between the two is that PRP is first generation, PRF is second generation. Those are the big differences with details that we talked about, and then just some processing differences as well. And just know that they are great. They have tons of growth factors in them. They are great for regeneration. We use them for everything from aesthetics to sexual wellness. So follow along some of our videos. We have tons of videos talking about PRP. And let me know if you have any questions that I haven't answered with this video, because I am, again, willing to deep dive into anything wellness or sexual wellness, or obviously aesthetics.